Smile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today we're going to recap on a couple of things about knowing the age of your patient. And I know you all are like, well, I know the age of my patient. I've got their birthday in my chart. No, that is a chronological age. You only know this age. You don't know this age and this age, and all three of these ages need to be factored into creating a treatment plan for your young patient. And I'm talking about phase one patients primarily, or patients under the age of 10. Orthodontists know that there are three different ages, and we talk about it when we do our case presentations. We say this patient is 8 years, 2 months, but their dental age, you know, is behind, or their dental age is more like age 7 or age 10, and their skeletal age is advanced, you know? So let's talk about that a little bit more, and we're just going to do a real high-level conversation today. If you want to dig more into anything regarding phase one treatment planning, early treatment planning, early intervention, interceptive airway, you should definitely check out all of our free education. We make it all completely free for you. It costs us money to produce and make, but we don't really make any money on this. So what we're doing is we're hoping that putting this really correct information out there, this unbiased, factual information out there, will help you provide more access to care for your patients and do better orthodontic treatment planning. If there's a way that we can play it forward, that's what we're doing. So in any case, let's talk about this. So for example, you might have a girl, maybe, matter of fact, one crossed my path yesterday from one of my private clients with Straightsmile Solutions. Yes, we do help doctors with their treatment plans. If they want help, you can check it out at straightsmilesolutions.com. Thank you. But patient was really, really advanced dentally. Patient was 7, was a chronological age, I believe it was 7 years, 2 months or something like that. And then patient had a very advanced dental age of more like 8.5. Patient had all sixes in, that's your first molars, as well as all incisors fully in, that's 7 through 10 and 22 through 26 were fully in. So that puts the patient at more like an 8.5 dentally. So patient is advanced. Now, skeletally, don't know. There's only a few ways you're gonna know about skeletal ages. One, you can take a hand wrist x-ray. If you wanna learn how to do that, it's really easy. If you've got a CEF plate or a CBCT that has a big enough plate, you can totally do it. You may need to ask the manufacturer a little bit more on guidance. They may not know. You may have to play with it. It's usually very similar settings that you use for a lateral CEF. So play with it. We do them all the time. I've always done it. It is, and I've created a really great monograph to help you guys understand how to read the bones in the hand, which I think is a lot easier than reading the cervical neck bones. And that is available. We have it available in our store. If you want to go to our store at Straightsmile Solutions, go to store. We have documents, and there is a document about how to read a hand wrist x-ray. We've simplified it a lot. So you kind of know, is my patient peak pubertal? Is my patient post pubertal? Is my patient not quite growing yet? So then you have some idea of the skeletal age. Why does this matter? Well, you need to know, because remember, girls can go through puberty at age 8. I mean, average might be 10 and a half, 11 now. Things have really changed over the last few decades. But many are 8 and some are 14, you know? And that makes a difference, because if you are trying to target growth modification, you're trying to grow a lower jaw, you're trying to advance an upper jaw to fix an underbite, you're trying to expand an upper jaw to fix a crossbite or to improve airway, things aren't going to happen if your patient is fully grown. And like I said, in some girls, this could be 8. So they could have a dental age of 7. They may only have 3 teeth in, but they might be done growing. It happens. So if you do not, you can't just look at the patient's chronological age and say, oh, they're 8, it's okay to wait. No, that is really ignorant. Because as an orthodontist, it's been so heartbreaking to me to have patients come in at 12, 13, 14, and to find out that we cannot do ideal treatment for them without jaw surgery because the general dentist screwed up and didn't refer the patient in. Now, that's why orthodontists like to say all patients need to come in by age 7 so we can evaluate them. If you guys don't have the tools to evaluate the patients, send them to us. Unfortunately, there's quite a lot of orthodontists that aren't that educated in this stuff. And they're fine with doing, you know, extractions to manage problems with bites, which I'm not fine with. So you really need, if you're not going to do interceptive treatment in your practice, you need to make sure you have an orthodontist who's airway friendly, who believes in non-extraction, who believes in early intervention, who understands the difference between a chronological, a dental, and a skeletal age, and the importance this puts into a treatment plan. Matter of fact, I really challenge you, if you're not going to be doing interceptive treatment in your practice, to make sure the orthodontist that you're referring to believes in all this. Bring up this conversation. Ask if that's part of their core values. And if you're sending them patients who clearly need early intervention and they're saying it's okay to wait till age 12, well, you have the wrong orthodontist. You need to find another one. Find another one to refer to. And if you don't have somebody to refer to, time for you to be doing this in your practice because it is the right thing to do. It's something, this is what honestly got me into consulting and less away from my private practice because I realized I'd have a bigger footprint, a bigger impact on changing lives because it is so heartbreaking to see adults who are suffering from airway disorders, to see older teens having to get a jaw surgery because somebody dropped the ball that should have known. So yes, I'm gonna preach it. But I'm going to keep preaching it until I change people's minds and until we can help these kids more. So hopefully this was educational for you. Keep this in mind whenever you see a little kid. All right. Thanks so much.